you double-click an object or drag it onto the screen, you'll be presented with a dialog. Most of the objects share a lot of common features. These common features are reviewed in this video, so each individual video doesn't have to repeat them. We'll use this push button object for this video, but these features will apply to almost all of the other objects. In the upper left, you can name this object. The user never sees this, it's just for your reference so you can easily identify it later. Below that, we see a preview of the object, and if it has any action, there'll be a way to simulate that by clicking the button. This is a push button, so it has a controllable preview. Note that the button on the screen also updates when you click on the preview control. Every change you make in this dialog will be reflected in the simulated view. So this is a great way to experiment with things without having to leave the dialog. This preview pane even keeps up with the size changes you make. For example, let's go change the size of this guy. I need to assign a tag first. If we change the size to something real wide and then go back into our dialog, sure enough, this preview pane tracks it one for one. I'm going to change that back real quick so we can do some other things with this. The label box allows you to add a label to the object on a screen. This always uses a portion of the object area, so it usually becomes a trade-off between having a static label or leaving room for the action text that you've chosen for that object. If you choose to use a label, let's go ahead and put something shorter in here. You can specify the location, whether it be on the top or the bottom, the color, whether it's normal or black, or inverse, and the alignment. Notice that when you drop down the alignment and drag over these, it shows you a preview of what that's going to look like on both the simulated pane and the real object. And of course, you can choose a font. The font choices usually allow the built-in fonts, or you can choose a window font if you want to. If the object requires text as part of its operation, in this case we have off text and on text, you'll be able to type in whatever you want there along with the colors and the alignments. Let's see, I'm in the on position right now, so these alignments will track as I move them around. I'm watching this guy over here. If I go to the off state, then these alignments will track. Most objects will require you to enter a tag for them to control or react to. See the videos on creating tags and tag databases and the other objects for how that's being used. Some objects allow you to draw an optional frame around some part of the object. In this push button, the frame is drawn around the action text. This also uses real estate within the button object, so be careful when you're using it that you leave yourself enough room for your text. Additionally, you can specify a theme type right here by selecting it from this drop-down. The current theme looks like this. We can change it to a single line. This is the border around the outside of the object. You can choose different kinds of look and feel for your objects. But again, remember, the more complicated the theme type, the more room it takes in your object. So it all becomes a trade-off on how much stuff you need to have in your object versus how many features you add to it. Most of the time, the simple line will work just fine. Some objects allow you to pick a style. For this push button, you can choose between round or circle. And again, the frame style kind of interacts with that. So now we have a round frame style as opposed to a rectangular one. If an object can take a user input, there will usually be an option to add a function key. So in addition to pressing the object on a touch screen, you can also use a function key to activate that object. Note that while there are 5 function keys on the panel, there's actually the option to use 10 function keys. Check out the video on setting up function keys 6 through 10 on how to use those extra function keys. Each object allows you to leave yourself a comment. We want to encourage you to do that. You'll be surprised at how much you forget after you've been away from your project for a while. Leaving yourself a comment on the intended purpose of this object is a great way to jog your memory and make projects more maintainable. Finally, each object has an invisibility option. If enabled, it allows the visibility of an object to be controlled by the PLC through a tag. You specify the tag that this object should monitor and under what conditions the object should be visible. You get to choose all the usual things. So in this case, as long as this tag is, let's say greater than a 1, the object will be visible. That's all there is for this video. be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.